Ryan Garcia's penchant for the unconventional persisted backstage at the Barclays Center as he received a surprise visit from Mike Tyson just hours before his bout against Devin Haney on Saturday evening. DAZN's coverage of the preliminary bouts had Garcia and Haney getting ready for the main event by seeing them train backstage. Garcia, whose eccentric online behavior has left fans puzzled, added a new twist to the mystery by embracing classical music. The Victorville, California native had a quartet serenading him as he limbered up and had his hands wrapped. Garcia uploaded a video of Tyson visiting his dressing room shortly after, with the musicians recording him getting ready. "Thank you, Mike, for showing," Garcia captioned the video, in which he compliments the boxing legend and tells him he will attend Tyson's fight against Jake Paul in July. Meanwhile, Haney remained his typically composed self as he readied for another significant bout, coinciding with Tyson's visit to his training camp situated across the arena. As the atmosphere around Garcia simmered with excitement, his theatrical antics leading up to the fight night were hard to ignore. However, backstage glimpses of the Dream, the reigning WBC super lightweight champion, revealed a stark contrast. An aura of calmness and unwavering focus enveloped him. Garcia stepped into the ring for Saturday's bout, boasting an impressive 24-1 record with an astounding 20 victories by knockout. Following his solitary defeat at the hands of Gervonta Davis in April 2023, Garcia swiftly regained his momentum, delivering a resounding knockout victory over Oscar Duarte in December of the same year. Meanwhile, Haney boasted an impeccable record of 31-0, clinching victory with 15 impressive finishes under his belt. His momentum surged with 4 consecutive triumphs, notably defeating George Kambosos Jr. twice in 2022 and securing wins over Vasily Lomachenko and Regis Prograis in 2023. However, Garcia sent Haney to the canvas on 3 occasions, dealing the WBC super lightweight champion his initial defeat. Despite securing victory through a majority decision, Garcia couldn't claim the title due to exceeding the weight limit. Throughout the buildup, Garcia's peculiar actions in public and on social media raised concerns about his level of commitment to the fight. It appeared evident that he hadn't dedicated sufficient time to his training regimen, considering he exceeded the 140-pound limit by more than 3 pounds on Friday. However, Haney found himself overwhelmed by the sheer velocity and force wielded by his opponent. He suffered from the very onset, succumbing to knockdowns in the 7th, 10th, and 11th rounds. Garcia emerged victorious, with judges scoring the bout 115, 109, and 114, 110 in his favor, though the third judge saw it as a draw with a score of 112, 112. The Californian 25-year-olds clashed in the ring 6 times during their amateur careers. However, Haney's journey as a professional boxer outshone his opponents, as he ascended to claim the undisputed lightweight championship before swiftly clinching the WBC title in his debut at the 140-pound weight class. Meanwhile, Haney, who suffered his first defeat, said, "He caught me early, but I was sleeping on it. Caught me by surprise." Haney appeared to have a grip on the match for a stretch. However, as Garcia launched his attacks, he unleashed a flurry of punches that caught Haney off guard, leaving him either unprepared or lacking the necessary tools to counter. Garcia had the audience singing his name by the finish. Garcia clinched a remarkable win following a stretch of unpredictable actions and extravagant assertions, including his insistence that he had summoned otherworldly beings. Garcia bellowed during his in-ring interview after the fight, "Come on, guys, you really thought I was crazy. You guys lost your own mind." In the ring, Garcia unleashed his left hook with precision, sending shockwaves in the 7th, 10th, and 11th rounds. His mastery of the punch was evident from the outset as he landed a thunderous blow in the opening round, shaking Haney to his core. Garcia said, "I just knew I had control after that. It's hard to recover from big shots. You know, maybe my conditioning wasn't my best, but at the end of the day, I got the job done." Haney dropped to 31-1, while Garcia increased to 25-1. Ryan Garcia had turned his back, But why? Garcia said when asked about the move, I don't know. I have ADHD, so I just start doing random things. At first, Haney found himself puzzled by the situation. However, undeterred, he relentlessly targeted Garcia's exposed back while Garcia remained focused on guarding his face and frontal area. Haney said, I thought the ref let him turn his back. A little too much. Ryan Garcia takes a swipe at the press. Garcia was upset during the in-ring interview and seemed to be directing his ire towards the media. He said, You guys hate on me because I'm pretty and expletive. At the end of the day, I've been boxing all of my life, and all I do is love God and try to help the children, and you guys straight hated on me. You guys do not love the truth. But after the fight, Garcia did not become furious. He said, I need a shot of beer, or like alcohol or something to get my mind going. You feel me? I'm just kidding. Man, can't you guys take a joke, man? Now let's delve deeper into the fight. So in the first round, Garcia lands a handful of hits. Garcia used a large left hand. Haney was amazing. Garcia goes for another left and combination. Haney responds by firing a right. Garcia continues to punch. Garcia is removing the load. As the round comes to an end, Haney steadies himself. Haney 9 and Garcia 10.
Round 2 unfolds with Haney asserting dominance from the outset, landing a flurry of precise lefts while Garcia responds with erratic swings. Haney maintains a calculated approach, steadily utilizing his left hand to control the pace. Garcia, no longer reckless, appears composed, hinting at untapped power waiting to be unleashed. A significant right hand from Haney finds its mark, momentarily stalling Garcia's momentum. Despite moments of inactivity, Garcia retaliates, reminding Haney of his presence in the ring. The round concludes with both fighters evenly matched at 19 points each. Meanwhile, round 3 unfolds with Garcia launching an overhand right, though it only grazes his opponent. Unfazed, Garcia continues his assault, yet fails to find his mark. Amidst the flurry, Haney manages to land a solid connection with his left. The fighters briefly tangle up, with Haney showcasing a cautious respect for Garcia's power while utilizing his jab effectively. Haney scores with successive hits, visibly irking Garcia, who appears increasingly frustrated. Haney's composure shines through, asserting control as the round ends with Haney leading 29 to Garcia's 28. In the fourth round, Garcia dials up his aggression, showing a newfound intensity. However, their dance in the ring leads to entanglements once more. Haney shifts gears, becoming the pursuer, while Garcia attempts to shield himself behind his left shoulder. Yet evading Haney proves futile. A precise left from Haney finds its mark, followed swiftly by Garcia's own counter with a powerful right. Despite Garcia's attempts, he finds himself on the defensive, retreating without much activity. The judges tally it up, Haney at 39, Garcia at 37. The fifth round unfolds with Haney expertly flicking out jabs, while Garcia throws a flurry of punches, yet none find their mark. Haney maintains dominance as Garcia's attempts fall short. Garcia's right hand misses again, followed by a brief grappling exchange. The energy of the first round feels distant as the crowd voices its discontent with boos. Suddenly, Garcia connects with a solid right and momentarily clinches Haney. The fighters are swiftly separated, revealing a hint of hesitation in Haney's demeanor. As the round concludes, Haney leads 49 to Garcia's 46.
The next witnessed Garcia adopting a more assertive approach, unleashing a formidable right followed by a precise left, suggesting trouble for Haney. Garcia's evident power superiority was palpable. However, Haney swiftly regained dominance, aggressively cornering Garcia and launching a flurry of strikes. Although cautioned for a back hit, it was Garcia evading Haney's advances. The crowd voiced their disapproval as both fighters momentarily slowed down. The scorecard reads, Haney 58, Garcia 56. Round 7 saw Haney aggressively pinning Garcia against the ropes, only for the two to swiftly disengage. Garcia seized the opportunity, connecting with a powerful left that sent Haney crashing to the canvas. As Haney struggled to regain his footing, Garcia pressed on with relentless aggression. However, the referee intervened, docking a point from Garcia for an untimely strike following a clinch. The bout continued with Haney experiencing further turmoil, hitting the floor twice more, though both instances were ruled slips amidst the chaos. Despite his valiant efforts, Haney appeared fatigued and unsteady, tallying 66 points against Garcia's 65. In the eighth round, we see Garcia hunting for the decisive punch. He pins Haney in the corner, yet the referee intervenes, granting Haney an unexpected escape. Surprisingly, Haney shows remarkable agility. The tempo gradually wanes as both fighters expend considerable energy. Haney's rights lack their initial sharpness, but he maintains a higher level of activity compared to Garcia. The judges score it at Haney, 76, Garcia, 74. In the ninth round, Garcia showcases his trademark move, repeatedly turning his back as Haney advances, cleverly absorbing left hands. Garcia then swiftly transitions back to the offensive, unleashing powerful shots. However, it's only a brief flurry. The judges score it, Haney 86, Garcia 83. Round 10 unfolds with Garcia unleashing a powerful right hook, followed by a swift left, sending Haney crashing to the canvas once more. Despite the knockdown, Haney manages to beat the count. Garcia presses the advantage, launching a relentless assault. Both fighters appear fatigued as they grapple in a clinch. Garcia continues his unorthodox tactic of momentarily turning his back on Haney. Another lightning-fast left from Garcia rocks Haney, leaving him visibly staggered. Garcia intensifies the onslaught with a flurry of punches, while Haney desperately tries to weather the storm. The judges' scorecards reveal a close margin, with Haney leading 94-93 over Garcia. The next round commenced with Haney initiating with a pair of left-handed jabs, displaying his readiness. However, both punches failed to connect. Garcia, on the other hand, carefully gauged Haney's movements, seeking the opportune moment to unleash his power. Haney adopted a more defensive stance after Garcia managed to land a glancing blow, momentarily halting the action as the two fighters grappled. Suddenly, a powerful right hook from Garcia found its mark, followed swiftly by a left jab that sent Haney crashing to the canvas for the third time in the match. Despite the knockdown, Haney managed to rise before the referee's count reached its conclusion. Garcia, fueled by the momentum, aggressively shoved Haney through the ropes, but the resilient fighter managed to return to the ring. The crowd erupted into chants of "Ryan, Ryan," signaling their support for Garcia's dominance in the round, with the scorecard now reading Garcia 103, Haney 102. In the next round, Garcia and Haney engage in a daring dance of punches, both aware of the pivotal moment. Garcia, unpredictable as ever, momentarily turns his back, only to find himself back in the center of the ring. Despite Haney's unsteady footing, he manages to connect with a solid jab. Is Garcia seeking the knockout blow, or is he merely coasting along? With a taunting gesture, sticking his tongue out at Haney, Garcia launches into a flurry of jabs. As the round concludes, Garcia leads with 113 points to Haney's 111. Indeed, Garcia was donning a crown as he made his way from his changing area to the ring. As the fight gets closer, Devin Haney and Ryan Garcia are preparing with different vibes. So that's all from today's video. If you enjoyed it, remember to leave a like, subscribe, and ring that bell icon so you never miss our upcoming videos. And don't forget to share your thoughts in the comments section. Stay tuned, and we will catch you in the next video.